allegiance to the flag,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call. Supervisor Vecchio? Councilman Wareheim?
Here.
Councilman Creighton?
Here.
Councilman Malloy?
Here.
Okay, the first public hearing for the evening is to consider amending the zoning code and the map of the town as petitioned by Edward and Patricia Martella for change of zone from wholesale service industry to professional business. Location is on Middle Country Road in St. James. Someone here on behalf of the applicant?
I am, Mr. Supervisor, members of the board. Good evening. My name is Vincent Tremarco. I represent the applicant. I've submitted the affidavits of posting and mailing to Maureen. Most of you might be familiar with the site. It's right behind Right Way Auto Body on Lake Avenue, almost. Right Way is on the corner, so it's almost on the corner of Jericho and Lake Avenue. We previously appeared before the planning board. I believe you have in your packet a favorable recommendation to your board from the planning board recommending approval. You also have from the planning department a favorable recommendation asking this board or your board to approve the application. The only thing I'd like to say is the professional business zoning, PB zoning, was enacted some years ago by this board in order to create a transitional zone from a more intense zone most of the time to a residential district. So you have the PB zone as a buffer between residential and a more intensive commercial. That's what we're asking the board to do tonight, to change the zone from WSI, which, as this board knows, permits much more intensive uses. The most notable is body shops, car dealerships, and things of that nature. Professional business would allow us to put offices and or an apartment or both on the second floor. It's a permitted use. And it certainly creates a better situation for the residential properties to the north. So we ask the board for its favorable consideration. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them.
Anybody in the audience wish to be heard on this matter? I'll move to close the hearing. Did you wish to be heard? Yes.
I arrived a little bit late for the hearing, but I believe this is the hearing on the rezoning matter of the King Cullen.
We need your name.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. Can I almost close the hearing?
Thank you.
Second.
Supervisor Becky?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
The next public hearing is to consider amending the zoning code and the map of the town as petitioned by King Cullen Grocery Company for change of zone from R10, 10,000 square feet residential district to central business district on property located on the east side of Washington Avenue. Someone here on behalf of this application?
I guess it's me again. I'm sorry, I thought there would be a presentation made by King Cullen or King Cullen's representative, so I was waiting for that.
Are you the counsel for King Cullen?
No, I'm not.
What are you?
I am counsel for a neighbor. My name is Angela Sapienza. I'm an attorney.
Well, you won't be able to speak until we hear the application.
That's what I believe you're waiting for.
You're going
to I was prompted to come up here, that's all.
Well, we hear that. Usually people get heard after the application
the
is presented.
I understand that. That's why I asked if the applicant was here and ready to be heard, that's all.
Are you, is there an apple, is there a counsel for the application for the King Cullen?
Thank you.
Huh?
we have any easels?
Good evening, Mr. Supervisor, members of the board. I apologize, I was out in the hallway conferring with my client. Vincent Pizzulli with law offices at 90 Merrick Avenue, East Meadow, New York, representing King Cullen Grocery Company. Before I begin, let the record reflect that I'm handing in the affidavit of mailing and affidavit of posting. The application before you this evening is a request to change the zoning of property located at 311 Washington Avenue from R10 to CB. The purpose of this request is to allow a 4,355 square foot expansion of the existing King Cullen supermarket. I'd like to note that I have received a copy of the planning staff department's recommendation to the town board with regard to this application, and that we concur in its recommendation to the board, and we accept, if this application is granted, the proposed conditions of approval. King Cullen was before this board once before in 1984, requesting a change of zone so it could construct the first addition to the supermarket. Then, as now, King Cullen needs to grow and remodel its store in order to meet customer expectations and demands. The current proposal would expand the store by 4,355 square feet, but it will not result in an overintensification of use, and it is not the kind of expansion that will generate a significant increase in the number of customers. The expansion is proposed in order to functionally redesign the store interior, widen the aisles, and improve the layout of the produce area so that the store will meet current industry standards and customer expectations for better service and selection. Mr. Supervisor, members of the board, at this point, in anticipation of some of the comments you may receive tonight, I'd like to hand up an exhibit and go through it with you so that you'll better understand some of the issues that may be presented to you tonight. If the clerk would like to mark this, you can mark it Applicant's Exhibit 1. The first sheet of the handout that I just presented to the board is a schematic picture of the site plan showing the original proposal for this property. King Cullen originally planned to construct a 7,000 square foot addition to this store. The area that's highlighted on the first sheet in pink is the additional area of the proposed expansion that would have to be constructed on the VFW property if this application were going to go forward. With this plan, representatives of King Cullen contacted the VFW, which owns tax lot 46, which is the lot that this, which is shown in pink on this map, with a request to meet and discuss a potential land swap to allow King Cullen to build on that corner of the property. As part of that proposal, King Cullen was proposing a land swap of an equivalent land area, and they met with representatives of the VFW in an attempt to negotiate a transaction that would benefit both parties. Those discussions took place on several occasions, even before I represented King Cullen, and they continued after I became attorney for this application. Unfortunately, those discussions never came to an acceptable conclusion, and the parties had to go their separate ways. Consequently, King Cullen revised its application and reduced the size of its expansion. And if you go to sheet 2 of the packet, you'll see that we eliminated the corner of the building that would have had to have been constructed on the VFW property, and instead that will just be a landscaped area under that schematic map. Now, to get to the nitty-gritty of the issue concerning the reason why we requested an agreement or a land swap agreement, I refer you to sheet number 3. The lot that's outlined in yellow is tax lot 46.1, and the fee owner of that lot is the VFW. The smaller lot below that that's outlined in pink is land owned and purchased by King Cullen. Everything on the lot that's outlined in yellow outside that red line that outlines the building and a little area to the north, to the west of the building, that area is leased to St. James Associates. St. James Associates is an entity, a holding corporation, a Stoller Associates entity. Stoller Associates ground leased that area shown on this map from the VFW, I believe back in 1984, 1985, or thereabouts. In fact, why should I guess? I have a copy of the lease with me. April 18th, 1985. And I'll hand up a copy of this lease, too, for the record. Please mark the copy of the lease I handed up as Applicant's Exhibit 2. Under the lease with the VFW, which was subleased to King Cullen by St. James Associates, King Cullen has the right to pave and park that area shown within the yellow lines outside the red line outlining the building. That's a 25-year lease with a right to extend it for an additional 20 years. Those options will be extended, and that lease will expire in 2031. Now, I'm pointing, even though these matters truly aren't relevant to the change of zone application, I am bringing them to the board's attention so the board can better understand some of the comments you may hear this evening. King Cullen has the right, as does its customers, to utilize the leased area in connection with its supermarket as a parking lot and a driveway, and it has done so since 1985. And at this time, I'm going to turn over the microphone to whoever wishes to speak next.
Okay. These people wish to be heard on this matter. Mr. Tim Riley. Well, let's hear him first, and then we'll have you. Sir?
My name is Jim Riley. I'm a taxpayer at 155 West 3rd Street in St. James. The property that's going to be rezoned adjoins my property. And I resided in St. James with my family from 75 to 86. I purchased 155 West 3rd Street in 2002 as an investment and possibly a retirement home. My concern is the traffic on Washington Avenue and the surrounding streets. And I noticed that they did install new no commercial vehicle signs on Washington, which, you know, is something to be done, but installing the signs will not stop the traffic. The smaller trucks, the potato chip trucks, the bread trucks, come down Washington, make a left on West 3rd to get out onto Lake Avenue. The larger tractor-trailer trucks know they have to go out Railroad Avenue to Northern Boulevard. And this is part of the concern, is the additional space they're adding here is going to cause traffic in the areas. I spoke to Brian Murphy, the manager over there, about the bread trucks and potato chip trucks, and he explained that he could speak to the drivers, but couldn't force them to obey the traffic laws. I understand that. I believe Brian doesn't have the authority to change the vendors, but I believe his superiors have the authority to tell the vendors that if you don't obey the traffic laws that we have in place, that we could ask for another vendor to come in here, and asserting the authority that they have. This is my concern with this expansion, is the traffic on Washington and the surrounding streets. When we have a problem right now with the stores the size it is, I think that expanding the store is just going to exacerbate the problem. And I don't believe code enforcement has the authority to write tickets for traffic like this. It has to be Suffolk County. And Suffolk County, with the budget cuts they have, the stretch so thin, they can't be attending to traffic problems in St. James. This is my concern, and I wish the board would adhere to my recommendations.
Thank you. Mr. Bartolo, did you, sir, are you representing somebody?
Mr. Supervisor, members of the board, Donald King, 75 East Main Street, Kings Park, New York. I was retained on Monday by the VFW, and I've had numerous meetings with them. The guys that I met who represent the post are very reasonable people. They'd like very much to get back together with Mr. Pizzulli and King Cullen and see if they can shake out what they couldn't shake out the first time. They're very concerned about their the surrounding area of their post, but I think there's a possibility, if they're willing to talk, I know that the members are willing to talk, and maybe we can reach an accommodation here that helps King Cullen and helps the VFW post. And perhaps the board could push them in that direction of both parties, and it may be a win-win for King Cullen and a win-win for the VFW. I'm not going to get into the specifics of my own concerns about the change of zone and what they're doing, but that's why I'm here tonight, and that's why the members are here tonight, to see if we can pull something together. I know that you guys are not going to vote tonight because there's no CEQA. There is head of the post is here. He'd like to say a couple of brief words as to his concerns, and we'd very much appreciate if we could put this thing together.
Just let me ask a question. You represent the veterans?
Yes.
They're not opposed to the zone change, which this is a hearing about the zone change.
Yes. We could theoretically wind up opposing the zone change down the road, but I thought in the first instance, if we could put something together that was satisfactory to the post, that they would come forward and recommend that the town board go forward and give King Cullen what they need.
Okay, well, there is a time period after this hearing.
Yes.
It's going to take some time to get the secret declaration.
Yes.
And that would seem to me that would be a...
That would be wonderful.
A great hiatus for the both parties to get together.
That would be great.
Okay, so that I think we can do that.
That would be terrific if you guys could put it together.
Okay.
And
we've heard you.
If it's okay, the head of the post would like to speak shortly.
Well, did he sign up? Well, the people who've signed, let's
see.
He
didn't sign. Okay.
Let's see the people who signed. Mr. Bob Kugler. Kubla, sorry.
Good evening, Supervisor. My name is Bob Kubla. I live on 254 Grant Avenue. I did have the opportunity to speak at the zoning meeting, and in return, Mr. Pizzulli stated that they didn't want to encroach on anybody's property, and basically King Cullen was doing this for the community and the customers of King Cullen. As you probably know, the store was originally built in 1960. They made changes in 84. At the time the changes were made, there was no change made to any of the loading docks or the area behind the store, which are on Railroad in the corner of Washington. My concern is I walk daily there with dogs. I go by there, and every day it looks like there's encroachment. Can I present this to the board?
Sure.
It's pretty much self-explanatory. As you see, the pictures on the left that are circled in red, the trucks delivering are all parked in front of the fire hydrant there. This is a daily matter. This isn't just pictures that were staged. These were taken randomly when I passed through the area. If you notice the other pictures, the pedestrians out on the road and the vehicles that have to go around the trucks in the area. And also the other pictures show unloading and parking of tractor and trailers and trucks on the Long Island Railroad parking lot, which the town just finished paving last year, I believe. I understand they say they want to make this better for the community, but they're already involving a problem there on the corner of Washington. My concern is if this zone is changed, the side of Washington there. The truck's going to be coming down there. They're going to be parked down there. Also, I've taken the time to speak to some seniors on the weekends, on Saturday, Sunday. They have no problem with the store the way it is. They're happy with the store. They like it because it's a smaller store. They don't have to take a half an hour to get over to where the milk is. As I said, my main concern is this for the community or is it for profits? I know they say they just want to make the store bigger. It's a little hard for me to believe that they want to spend this much time and money just to make aisles bigger, unless they're going to bring more product in, which means more traffic. Thank you.
Frank Todaro.
My name is Frank Todaro. I live at 18 4th Avenue in Smithtown. I am the commander of the VFW 395 at 460 Lake Avenue in St. James. We do not oppose King Cullen expanding their store. Our concerns is the way that they will expand the store in relation to our property. I understand that they're told that with a CB zoning, they can build to the property line. At the present time, our northern property line is covered by their store. Their store is right on the property line. If they want to build this building to the west of us, they're going to build it right to the property line. They have the property on the south side. We're afraid that we're going to be, I call it encroaching, but everybody tells me that I'm wrong, but we're going to be crowded in. We're going to be crowded in, and we feel that we're going to be crowded out. When we entered into the agreement to lease the property 25 years ago, we were told it was for parking only. And we were told that they would be allowed to egress our property onto Lake Avenue. And now it seems they want to use the property more than what was agreed to 25 years ago. Again, without getting into specific details, I don't know if that's the purpose of this meeting, but we feel that they're moving us out. And we want to stay in St. James as much as they want to stay in St. James, possibly more. We just hope that you would consider our point of view when you allow them to build this building in order to change the zone. As I feel it's I say encroaching on our property and on our usage of our property. Thank you,
Mr. Todaro. Your lawyer you hired.
Yes, sir.
I made a statement, I don't know if you heard that he wishes to have some time to negotiate with King Cullen.
Our and you could ask Mr. DeRubius, our position has always been that we will meet with King Cullen.
Okay, well, okay. So there will be sufficient time for King Cullen to meet with your attorney on the matter that you're concerned about.
As long as there's sufficient time and sufficient agreeableness, we're more than happy to meet anytime, anywhere that they want to.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Sapienza?
Third time's a charm. Good evening, my name is Angela Sapienza. I represent my brother, Frank Sapienza, who resides at 302 Washington Avenue. As we all know, Washington Avenue is right behind the King Cullen, and he lives adjacent to the site which has been proposed for rezoning. I'm here tonight because of concerns for the residential neighborhood that is directly behind the King Cullen. When organizing my comments for tonight, I thought an interesting place to start was directly with the Smithtown local law, specifically section 322-2, which outlines the purposes for zoning. I believe that this zone change directly injures the orderly growth of development in the St. James area. Specifically, I do not believe this development is supported by the comprehensive plan or by positive long-term objectives for St. James. I believe that this zone change will lead to the overcrowding of land. The lots in this area are of smaller size than other lots throughout the Smithtown area. In addition to that, I believe that this will increase traffic congestion. Anyone who is familiar with St. James knows that Lake Avenue is a two-lane road with no double yellow line, with on-street parking, with copious curb cuts, numerous ingresses and egresses to stores, restaurants, pharmacies, etc. I myself personally experienced this recently. My sister was in a car accident on Lake Avenue due to traffic congestion. Larger store typically means more traffic coming into the area. Although the size of the store will be increasing, the site plan does not provide for any additional parking. There is already an issue, as an earlier speaker pointed out, with commercial vehicles being parked and blocking ingress and egress, blocking residential driveways and entryways. In addition to this, I feel as though this rezoning will adversely affect the value of buildings and the value of land in this area. The commercial, by rezoning this lot as commercial, ultimately what can happen in the future is would be beyond this board's control or the planning board's control. Either King Cullen or future takers in title would be able to develop this land in a commercial manner consistent with the CB commercial the CB uses, which include dry cleaning, funeral homes, laundromats, taverns, restaurants. Obviously, this list is not exhaustive, but it's just a sampling of the many things that may be developed in that area. Also, I just wanted to point out one other thing about pedestrian traffic. The extension of the grocery store would also harm pedestrian traffic in that there would be more vehicles in the area. People that would be brought to the store would not necessarily be those who are already walking to the store, but would be more vehicles. In closing, I would just ask that you take a careful look at the zoning code, at the proposed rezoning site, and the surrounding area before making your determination. Thank you.
Okay, no others wish to be heard on the King Cullen matter, so I'll move to close the hearing.
Second.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Mr. Vecchio? Councilman Creighton?
May I just make one final remark before you close the hearing?
Okay.
To be very brief, first of all, I want to thank the members of the VFW that showed up tonight and their representative, and we'll be happy to speak with them. I just wanted to point out two things before we close the record tonight. In its prior change of zone approval in 1984, the board imposed a condition that the existing house at 311 Washington Avenue remain as a residential use. And the proposal before you is consistent with that approval and condition, and we will not, and we will continue to use 311 Washington as a residential use. And in response to the last commentator.
Well, we're not going to have a back and forth.
No, we're not going to have a back
and forth. We're not going to have a back and forth,
Council. But I just want to indicate to the board that this is a local supermarket. With this addition, it'll be less than 40,000 square feet. It's still a local grocery store. It's not designed to encourage traffic from any other town. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Move the vote, please.
Need a second? Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Thank you, Frank. Next public hearing is to consider proposed amendment to Chapter 221 of the Code of the Town entitled Property Maintenance as it relates to bamboo.
Good evening, Supervisor. Good evening, members of the board. My name is Janice Hansen. I'm an assistant town attorney. The purpose of this public hearing is for the board to consider a proposed amendment to Chapter 221, our property maintenance chapter, of the town code. The amendment would provide for the regulation of bamboo by adding a section to the town's existing property.
We can't hear the record in the back.
The amendment would provide for the regulation of bamboo by adding a section to the town's existing property maintenance ordinance, which would require all owners, tenants, or occupants to keep any bamboo on their property 10 feet setback from any property line, street, sidewalk, or public right-of-way.
Keep going.
That's all I have.
That's all you have to say?
Yes.
Okay,
that's
well, you best be prepared for a lot of questions. Okay, so you can sit. Okay, where would those block? We would ask that each of the persons desiring to speak will limit their conversations to 3 minutes. So we'll begin with the first, Mr. James. Is this Kirby? Yes. 92 Oak Avenue. Is there Mr. James? Oh, he is in the back. Okay.
Oops. My name is James Kirby. Excuse me. I reside at 92 Oak Avenue, Smithtown. And I'm here this evening to give support to what the board is trying to do in terms of controlling the growth of the invasive bamboo here in our area. You know, living on Oak Avenue and have firsthand experience treating and dealing with this bamboo, it gives you an idea of what can happen down the road if it isn't under control. So I agree with the board what you're attempting to do. It isn't easy. It's kind of a new road the board is taking here. I'm sorry. Yeah, okay. I say it's a new road the board is taking here with a new program of this invasive bamboo. And I'd like to get a start on this by seeing if you can pass this amendment tonight or in the near future and see how we can control this down the road. I've had this bamboo in our yard from day one, and our surrounding neighbors have it as well. And we've been trying to control it the best we can. So I think that we have some amendments to the local law on maintenance of property. I think perhaps it's a step in the right direction. Thank you.
Joe Mercurio, 6th Avenue.
Hi, yes, my name's Joe Mercurio. I live at 252 6th Avenue, St. James. And I have bamboo grown in my yard for over 20 years. I have it in control. I have a retaining wall that keeps it in check. I don't think I should have to take it out with a grandfather clause, because I have it under control. I really don't want to see this change. If it's a new property, and they can learn how to control it, no problem. I can show them how to do it. You can't control it. But I don't think it's fair for anybody that already has it in control to have it taken out on their own expense. That's all I have to say.
Good point. Thank you. Jonathan Lara.
Good evening. My name is Jonathan Lehrer. I'm a professor of ornamental horticulture at Farmingdale State College. I'm also a member of the Scientific Review Committee of the Long Island Invasive Species Management Area. And as some of you know, we did evaluate these running bamboo in the genus Philostoces, which is most of what we're, I believe, concerned with today. And the plant did not rank high enough to be placed on the Suffolk County Do Not Sell list. There's a number of reasons for this, which I'd be happy to address if somebody had more interest in that topic. But I do want to make clear that just because this plant has not been placed on the Do Not Sell list, that does not mean that it is an appropriate plant for typical suburban landscapes. Our mandate on the Invasive Plant Committee that I'm part of is to evaluate plants according to their ecological, biological, invasive potential. And that is a separate concept from their behavior in a garden setting. So I don't want it to be misconstrued that just because these running bamboos are not placed on the Suffolk County Do Not Sell list, that this in some way invalidates the concerns that are being raised today. And I can also say that as a horticulturist as a professor of horticulture that in my view, I do not recommend running bamboos as components of typical suburban landscapes because their aggressive growth habit in time causes problems in most landscape situations. I would agree that the plant can theoretically be controlled. The problem all too often is people plant bamboo or some other plant without full knowledge of what the potential of the plant is, or the people abandon the property or move on, the plant is left, and eventually it runs wild and can cause damage to neighboring properties. So again, in closing, my main purpose in being here today is to, I think, just reinforce the point that just because these running bamboos are not placed on the do not sell list, that should not be misconstrued as a license or a statement of support for the installation of these plants in suburban landscapes.
Jerry Rubin, 19 Roseanne Court.
My name is Jerry Rubin. I've been a Smithtown resident for 42 years, and I've also had the problem with bamboo. And you hear some of the people who come up who say they can control the bamboo. Let them control the wind and the seed and the leaves that fall off, come onto your property, the seeds start to grow, all of a sudden you have a bamboo shoot. You have a pool, you have to clean out the skimmers from these leaves that fall in. Okay, you have a heater, they clog up. Okay, the neighbor behind me, his fence is now encroaching on mine because of the growth and the weight of the bamboo, and eventually I may have to replace the fence. So this is a problem that the neighbor has to see, the person who grows the bamboo has to see, okay, because it affects us. And if they don't take any interest in what they're doing, then it becomes a problem for both parties.
Thank you. Gerald Aletto.
My name is Gerald Aletto. Constituent Anthony Corbo could not be here tonight, and he felt strongly enough in support of the bamboo ordinance that he prepared the following statement to be read into the record. Dear Mr. Vecchio and town council members, my name is Anthony V. Corbo, and I am a resident of Smithtown for the past 28 years. I am another homeowner who is suffering with an invasive plant, running bamboo. I am wrestling with the onslaught of bamboo running over into my backyard from my rear neighbor's property. Every day, especially during May and June, and very humid periods, I go out into my yard and pull up bamboo shoots. I try to reach down and pull up the root, filling up a leaf bag a week with stems and leaves. If not for the weeding, the bamboo would overtake my yard. Since I have a pool, I am required by law to maintain fencing. In July 07, I had to reinforce the rear fence at a cost to me of $500 since the bamboo was pushing the fence down. On June 8, 2011, I had to replace the entire fence since the entire fence was now damaged by bamboo. The cost was $1,360. I am so grateful for your interest in the problem many of us are experiencing. The development and enforcement of a zoning law to prevent bamboo from being planted is so important. However, it is also imperative that the existing homeowner who planted bamboo be forced to remove this invasive plant from their property and their surrounding neighbors. I am sorry I'm not able to be with you tonight, for a job commitment forces me to be out of town. Thank you for your concern in a serious matter. Sincerely, Anthony V. Corbo, 25 Dale Lane, Smithtown, New York.
Thank you. Can I get a copy of that letter? Keith Aletto.
Good evening, honorable members of the Smithtown Board. My name is Keith Aletto, and I reside in the town of Smithtown on Oak Avenue with my wife, Anne Marie, and 4-year-old daughter. I would first like to start off by thanking you all for considering an ordinance on bamboo. I was able to obtain a copy of the town's proposal on this matter, and I feel, although it is a step in the right direction, several things would still need to be addressed. Does this ordinance grandfather current property owners who have this invasive bamboo? If not, I believe it should be clearly stated. As you are all aware, this invasive bamboo has affected several property owners within the town of Smithtown. I myself have been contacted by six other homeowners, all of which have tried to battle this disruptive and invasive plant. Invasive bamboo has punctured through pool liners, damaged pool heaters, destroyed fencing, collapsed cesspool lines, pushed over basement foundations, destroyed other landscape vegetation, and pushed its way through brick and concrete patios. These are just a few of the horrific stories I have heard or have witnessed firsthand. Your proposed ordinance states that all bamboo must be kept 10 feet from any property line. I urge you to reconsider a minimum requirement of 40 feet from any property line, as will be adopted in West Bradford Township, Pennsylvania. Also, a root rhizome barrier be installed completely around all roots of the plant. The town should also be made aware that bamboo will grow between 35 and 40 feet in some cases. A 10-foot horizontal band would not take into consideration 40-foot stalks that lean onto surrounding property owners' structures or land, public right-of-ways such as roadways and sidewalks, or public utilities such as power lines and cable lines. A 40-foot band would also assist in maintaining some control and early detection on underground rhizomes that may have escaped a barrier. I have personally witnessed underground rhizomes that have spread undetected and resurfaced 30 feet down the property line. At this time, the bamboo is currently in my rear neighbor's yard and has affected three property owners and is very close to encroaching on three other property owners. In closing, it is important that environmental and health is not affected in abatement. With many children within the Smithtown neighborhoods, herbicides are not an option. The best option should be excavation. Thank you.
Thank you. Anne Maria Leto, 86 Oak Avenue.
Okay, are you going to take that off of my time? Thank you. Good evening, honorable members of the Smithtown Board. My name is Amrie Aletto, and my husband Keith and I live in Smithtown for the past 6 years. We have the unfortunate experience of having on our property running bamboo, which is known as Vilostachys aureus yellow groove bamboo or yellow groove bamboo. This running bamboo has encroached and penetrated into our yard from our neighbor's backyard, where they placed a corrugated steel barrier in the ground on their property to protect their in-the-ground pool, but never fully enclosed in bamboo to protect their neighbor's property. As a result, we have spent over $15,000 to place two rhizome barriers to slow down the invasion of bamboo onto our property. We, like other Smithtown residents, have been faced with this never-ending battle to remove and remediate this invasive plant, which is also considered a grass. Therefore, we are extremely appreciative to the board hearing this public voice on moving forward to enact an ordinance. Many horticultural authorities have informed us that if not thoroughly removed and kept out, not only will it continue to invade and damage residential yards and structures, it can cross whole yards,
grow under walls, and eventually end up in city infrastructure. Running bamboo in particular is the almost unique in the plant world because of its rapid invasiveness and potential for destruction. This is much more than a landscaping issue. I would like to quote Carl Rowland from the American Bamboo Society of Southern California, past president, an old Chinese proverb about running bamboo. It is said the kind of bamboo that the first year it sleeps, the second year it creeps, and the third year it leaps. For many Smithtown residents, we are at the leap phase and beyond. I have handed out to the board and prepared a binder that I will not go through in its entirety, and I have included an index to provide further information. However, I would like the members of the board to turn to Section 7, which is the last section of the binder. Okay? I'm not going to go through, like I said, this binder, but I want to go through a couple of these pictures. Running bamboo, the first picture is running bamboo without barriers to see and demonstrate the invasiveness. On the second page is the actual spikes from running bamboo rhizomes. These were seen in our yard. And then to go to the fourth pictures, you have one of the many seasonal bamboo cutting. You can see us taking down the bamboo line there. And then a dump truck of topsoil to replace the excavated soil with bamboo rhizomes. You have to replace the soil because you don't want recurrence. And then finally, number 10, the force of the underground bamboo rhizome completely cracked and pushed over cement foundation wall to an outside basement entrance. Also, our cesspool line was infiltrated and had collapsed. In closing, I respectfully ask the town board, is this considered normal property maintenance? Anyone who has the misfortune would probably say no to that question. I most urgently request the town not only enact a nuisance ordinance, but also require the abatement of the invading bamboo in its entirety as soon as possible under current code as a very real nuisance and menace that it is, okay, and to keep it abated. Thank you for your consideration.
Eileen Taborski, 24 Tower Place.
Good evening. In the interest of time, I'm going to read a written statement. I'm a master gardener trained by Cornell Cooperative Extension. I also state that bamboo is in the grass family, and because of that, it stores up nutrients in the root system and can go into dormancy just as grass can when a drought comes, and it comes back again and again. Like crabgrass, its roots go out in all directions. One plant just keeps sending up more and more shoots. I have never seen a bamboo yet that doesn't spread, but even a 10-foot buffer would be a help. Then for the first time, my neighbor will be cutting more of his bamboo than I am, and he'll know how much work I have been doing for years. I have dug into healthy roots of it, which already have come 20 feet into my property, but have not sent up any shoots to indicate where it was. It just goes and goes, and you don't know where it is. It has to be cut with a sharp hatchet to the ground level, because the woody base is as hard as a stone. It's like petrified wood. It's a tripping hazard and a lawnmower destroyer. It takes at least 10 years to decompose. New roots keep coming up, and the new shoots will grow a foot a day. I have seen it get to be 35 feet also. I know that it gets that big. If it gets into any of our beautiful streams and wetlands, there'll be no way to eradicate it. It has a waxy coating on its leaves, so sprays cannot be absorbed. A chainsaw can't cut it because the stem is so fibrous that it pulls the chain right off the saw. Only a bulldozer could dig it up, dig up the roots, and you can't do that in a wooded area without killing the trees. It's the worst plant I've ever met and can grow to 35 feet tall. I definitely feel it should be, any new plants should be banned from the town. I brought a very, very simple demonstration for people who may not understand it. These are two pieces of old dried bamboo that were cut. I did not have a root section, so I'm going to do my demonstration with these two pieces, okay? This is what the root system looks like at the base of a tall growing piece of bamboo. The roots are very close together and hard as stone, and they grow out in every direction. This would be, if I can get this through here, this would be like this. Just give me 1 second more. I'm almost done. When the roots grow out, the roots look similar to the bamboo itself. They go out sideways, and they also have these little joints coming up every couple of inches apart. Every joint has the ability to produce new shoots. It may not produce it right away. It may run for 20 feet before it produces a shoot out on the end. You don't know where it is. The roots on these sections have a different look. It looks like a fibrous root. I feel like if people know how the plant grows, they will understand it better. The other thing is, you cannot, to get rid of a bamboo grove, you have to cut every single bamboo tree, branch, sprout. It will keep reappearing for 2, 3, 4 years because the roots are very strong. Because it starts out as one plant with runners, and every single plant is connected. So to get rid of it, you have to get rid of every single plant. And thank you for any help you can give us.
Thank you. Robert DiFiore, 141 Gibbs Pond Road.
Yes, Mr. Vecchio and the board. My neighbor has bamboo, and it gets frustrating when they come to you and they say, sorry for the bamboo. I'm sure everybody else has heard that too. They don't care about what goes to the other people's property, and it's destroyed. It's, as I stand there in my yard and I watch this army of bamboo approaching my property, it's just tough on me. I have a whole acre. They have an acre piece of property. For me to put a barrier up, I would have to dig across 195 feet of my yard. Their property is like a mushroom shape. My son has the tax map here. If they keep letting this go, it could affect eight properties along their whole edge. It's not right. And I appreciate that you are trying to do something to help us. Thank you.
I'm not so sure I could read the last name. Mark, 5 Frank Street.
Fredrickson,
sorry.
Good evening. My name is Mark Fredrickson. I'm a resident of Smithtown. My wife and I moved here in 2007. We purchased a home that had bamboo. We probably wouldn't have planted it on our own, but unfortunately, it was there. It was poorly managed, poorly contained. However, it was very pretty. It provided adequate privacy for us. We like the idea of bamboo. I understand everyone's concern that it grows out of control, unruly neighbors who won't take care of it. However, my wife and I have spent tens of thousands of dollars to contain it. We have dug down 40 inches. We have contacted Cornell Horticultural Society. We have contacted companies out in California. We have done our due diligence to contain it. We approached our neighbors. We said, do you want it gone? Do you want us to get rid of it? Would you like us to go out and do what we can to get it off your property? They responded, no, we actually like it. We like the privacy it provides us. So we kept it. But we did put down the barrier. We do clip it when we need to. We never see it come over the barrier. As I mentioned, we dug down 40 inches, over 3 feet. We put down a barrier. A lot of people said it will never contain it. It has contained it. We have done our job. We have spent tens of thousands of dollars in digging trenches, in doing what we can to protect our neighbors. If you guys were to allow this amendment to pass, it would cost my wife and I another tens of thousands of dollars to get rid of it, to bring in topsoil, to bring in dirt, to level it, to do everything that we can to get rid of it. It is simply an impossibility for a young family that is trying to survive in Smithtown. We just simply cannot do it.
And it doesn't ban the bamboo.
It's on the property line.
It asks you to contain it 10 feet from the nearest property line.
I understand that, but it's on the property
line. Where was your barrier?
The barrier is on our side. We asked them if they'd like it on their side. They
How far is it from the property line?
The bamboo is literally on the property line. We have contained the bamboo.
The barrier is where?
The bamboo is on our side. We have another 200 feet of barrier. We asked them if they'd like it on their property. They said no, thank you. We had the bulldozer. We had the backhoe to do it. They said no, thank you. Leave it as is.
No, my question to you is, the barrier that you've installed
on our property.
Is it 10 feet from the property line?
No, it is on the property line. We have about
it's on the property line. Okay.
3 feet of bamboo that grows along the property line that has been contained on three edges.
Okay.
And I understand everyone's going to say, well, it grows around that. But what we did was we went out another couple of feet, 20 feet, 15 feet. And what we do is we try and make sure that it doesn't get anywhere near it. We try and maintain that it's 15 feet away from that. But on the other side of the fence, there is no barrier because the neighbor said, no, thank you. We actually want it to grow. We like it. We like the idea that it provides us all this privacy. So that is my concern, and I hope that you consider what I've said here, that it would cost us a lot of money to get rid of it. Simply an impossibility. So thank you.
Thank you. Norma Fredrickson? Okay. Dominic Salerno, 1 Wexford Court.
Good evening, Mr. Supervisor and members of the board, ladies. I've been a resident of Smithtown for 46 years. I'm a former member of the Board of Zoning Appeals for 10 years, and I served as a chairman of the Board of Assessment and Review for 8 years. So I got a little understanding how the town works. Bamboo is a very highly invasive plant, and I want to congratulate the board for addressing this situation. I don't think there's too many easy answers. It's something that has to be thought out. Every case is different, okay? My neighbor has put some bamboo in, but she very graciously agreed to put in a wall, a barrier between the two. Those sketches that you're looking at, you'll see is a sketch of my house, the garage, and you can see those bamboo plants. My garage is 10 foot, 12 feet from her fence. You can see how the bamboo has filled the void between the fence and my garage. The first photo, photo number one, shows the bamboo growing over the top of my car that's parked in front of my garage. It grows. It grows. It's a plant that doesn't belong in this area. Now, what happens? It also is going to affect property values. You go look at a house and it's got bamboo next to it. That house is going to be reduced in value. That's not fair to the person who's complying to the code and to the laws. He's got bamboo, so his property now is reduced in value. Does he come before the Board of Assessment and ask for a reduction in taxes? Is it going to get granted? His house is not as valuable if it was no bamboo next to him. It's not an easy situation. But I do encourage the board, thank you for your input, and hopefully it has to be examined case by case. Thank you.
Thank you. Eileen, I'm sorry, I can't read the name. 31 Colonial Road.
My name is Eileen Housel. I live at 31 Colonial Road in Smithtown. For over 5 years, I've been battling bamboo from my neighbor. When he put it in, he said to us he was putting it in, it might spread, but he was putting in a barrier. Needless to say, his barrier has not controlled the bamboo. By the way, you might be interested, very shortly, it has already started to invade the playground at New York Avenue building, because that's what we back onto is that building. Another problem with the bamboo is that this winter, with all the snow, it came over, it's on our property line running from front to back, it blocked our driveway. My son had to go out and cut it down in order for us to get out of the house. My husband is handicapped. Fortunately, we were in Florida at the time, or he would not have been able to get out of the house. It would have been necessary. My one concern is, if you grandfather this in and you want the bamboo removed, who's going to be responsible? I'm a senior citizen. I'm on a fixed income. And I really don't have the money to take it out. Is it going to be my responsibility, or is it going to be my neighbor's responsibility?
Mary Ann Pino.
Good evening, Mr. Supervisor and members of the board. I'm a resident of St. James who purchased, my husband and I purchased a home in September of 2008. I am concerned that the proposed amendments to Chapter 221 regarding bamboo are too broad and overbearing. The proposed ordinance, as written, does not accomplish the goal of impeding root penetration from one property to an adjoining neighbor. It will cause a burden to homeowners, will create financial hardship, may negatively impact the environment, and will deprive homeowners of the enjoyment of their properties as they presently exist. There is nothing that says that running bamboo will only travel 10 feet and will not invade someone else's property. Therefore, the language spelling out the amount of feet is irrelevant to the issue at hand, and it would be more constructive to incorporate language that individuals are required to install a root barrier system to prevent intrusion onto another property. The home that we purchased did have in existence a root barrier system to prevent the adjoining property's bamboo from penetrating the property that we own, and it has been successful in accomplishing that for 2.5 years. Running bamboo has been widely used for years as privacy screening, and many homeowners, including myself, purchased properties in Smithtown with bamboo already existing on it or a view of same of adjoining properties. To impose an ordinance requiring homeowners to remove bamboo if it is within 10 feet of their property will cause a burden to homeowners and create a financial hardship and not accomplish the goal of preventing root penetration. Such a requirement could adversely affect air quality, groundwater, soil, drainage, and have an impact on the ground surface with excavation. We have investigated the various methods of removing the bamboo as well as the cost involved in recreating the privacy screening, which is approximately 108 feet wide, and the cost exceeds $8,000 for us to go ahead and reestablish the enjoyment. There is a less restrictive and less costly way to accomplish the objective of preventing root penetration by requiring a root barrier system for those homeowners who have bamboo. The desired goal of this ordinance is to inhibit bamboo root intrusion. Setbacks nor requiring removal within 10 feet of an individual's property line will accomplish the goal. My husband and I have always and continue to pride ourselves on maintaining our property. I truly believe that this is a balancing process, weighing the respective interests of all homeowners involved. The gravity of undue harm caused must be balanced against the burden of preventing harm. We believe that it is imperative that prior to enacting or improving this proposed ordinance, the town of Smithtown should examine the environmental and economic implications of such an ordinance on the entire Smithtown community to prevent unintended consequences. Thank you for allowing me the opportunity to speak in opposition to this proposed ordinance.
Mrs. Pino,
yes.
You said you have a barrier?
Yes. I was in touch with the prior homeowners.
Right.
And prior to selling us the house, they installed a barrier because the fence was moved, and when they moved the fence prior to us closing, we took 10 feet. And their landscaper advised them to install this barrier, otherwise the bamboo that the neighbor planted behind, and it's 40 feet high.
So if
you say 10 feet and somebody has another 30 feet of it, the roots can run 30 feet, according to Cornell University.
But if you have the barrier, then the roots won't...
I have no bamboo shoots. I mean, you're welcome to any...
So then you would not be come under this ordinance, as I understand it.
Yes, I would.
Tell me why.
Because the ordinance, as written, says that you cannot have bamboo within 10 feet of a property line. So, as written, it does not go ahead and reach the objective, which is to stop the root penetration. The only thing that can successfully do that, whether it's 5 feet or 3 feet or 20 feet, is to install a root barrier system.
Well, let me read you this, and I don't know where I'm going wrong here. The proposed ordinance requires that the bamboo not be planted, maintained, or permitted to exist within 10 feet of any street, sidewalk, public right-of-way, or property line.
Okay, so my rear property line, it runs up to my property line, as it does for other individuals that have come up here today to speak. So by Smithtown's proposed ordinance, you are telling all homeowners in Smithtown, so there is an equal effect on both the homeowners that are complaining and the homeowners that have it, to the impact. You're asking all of these homeowners, and we have no idea, does Smithtown Board have any idea how many homeowners will have to remove bamboo? And what happens to the bamboo? The Highway Department has been picking up dump trucks of bamboo that we've been removing to maintain the grove. And I want to know what happens to this bamboo. Is it recycled, and we're picking up free mulch that contains the seeds of the bamboo?
Good point.
You know, what are the ecological effects here? What are we going to do to the environment?
You and I spoke on the phone yesterday.
Yes.
Every amendment to a code or statute must have an environmental review. All the comments made here tonight are taken into account by the environmental department.
Has an environmental review been done by the town of Smithtown?
You didn't hear me.
Okay.
I said before this amendment could be adopted, it must pass an environmental review. Environmental department weighs all the comments that are made here and researches the problem, and then will either issue a negative declaration or a positive declaration as to whether the ordinance should be adopted.
What about the economic hardship? I know that there has been case law that has said
that all comes into environmental review.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you. Doug, sorry about this one too. I can't, the PAULLA 183
Pacella.
Wow.
Good evening. My name is Doug Pacella. I'm going to read a statement from Stephen M. Lester. He's an attorney with Labradella, Lester and Associates, and he could not attend tonight. I'm an attorney who has represented numerous property owners in New York and across the United States who have fought with their neighbors over invasive bamboo. Based on my experience, the courts and the common law of the state of New York and other states are ill-equipped to deal with this growing suburban problem. Local legislation, such as the proposed ordinance you consider tonight, is my client's only hope for solution to save their properties. In addition to my legal experience representing private homeowners whose property has been damaged by other property owners' bamboo, I have served as legal counsel to the town board minority at the town of Hempstead since 2000. Therefore, I bring a unique perspective to this issue, serving as an attorney for both town council members and private homeowners. I appreciate the difficult task faced by the town board, which has to balance fairly its citizens' rights to plant what they want on their own property with other citizens' rights to have their property protected from invasive and destructive plant species. I represent Keith Aletto and Anne Marie Aletto of Smithtown, New York, in their lawsuit against their neighbors. The Aletto's neighbors have maintained and allowed to grow onto the Aletto's property a particularly invasive species of bamboo commonly known as yellow grove bamboo. The Aletto's litigation against their neighbors was based on the legal theory of private insurance and was not successful. The reason for the Aletto's defeat in the court was ironically that they had done such a good job at beating back the invasive bamboo. The jury concluded that the bamboo did not substantially interfere with their use and enjoyment of their property, which is one of the elements required to prove a private nuisance. However, had the Aletto's failed to make the enormous effort to rid their property of the invasive bamboo, they would have been accused of failing to mitigate their damages, another legal theory that could be used to bar a remedy in a court of law. This is why legislation is needed on this issue, and common law courts are not equipped to provide a remedy for this suburban scourge. I have reviewed the town of Smithtown's proposed amendment to its code. I believe the proposed ordinance represents a fair balance of property owners' rights and obligations. The ordinance does not ban outright the planting or maintenance of bamboo on property. Rather, it simply requires that such bamboo not be within 10 feet of any property line, street, sidewalk, or public right-of-way. In theory, this is a fair balance of property owners' rights. My concern about the ordinance arises from issues related to enforcement. It is one thing for the town board to pass this amendment and another for the appropriate town department to enforce the amended ordinance so that it protects its citizens' property rights. I urge the town to adopt this ordinance and enforce it vigorously. Violators of the ordinance should be advised of the expensive cost of this problem. I thank the town of Smithtown for taking the lead in addressing this growing problem. Thank you.
Thank you. Laura DiLorenzo, 8 Hague Place, Kings Park.
Good evening, Supervisor Vecchio and the town board. My name is Laura DiLorenzo, and I own 8 Hague Place in Kings Park since 2002. My neighbor planted a running bamboo grove for privacy along 100 feet of fence line, which is shared with my backyard and my front yard. The bamboo's underground rhizomes have run underneath the majority of my backyard and are approaching my house's foundation. I approached my neighbor to ask him what his future plans were for the bamboo and explain to him how his bamboo has created a burden for me. He informed me that he had no intention of taking it down nor helping me with containment nor the removal of the bamboo from my property. I was spending 5 hours per week from March through November to remove stalks from my property. To help prevent future rhizomes from coming over from his property, I had to install an underground root barrier system and disconnect his grove from my property, which cost me $1,500. The bamboo on my side still grows despite the fiberglass wall, and since I cannot afford $7,000 that it would cost for a professional rhizome removal, I am still spending at least 5 hours per week removing bamboo from my property to prevent it from reaching my house's foundation. I support the proposed amendment to the town code. My neighbor's bamboo has created a burden on my finances and my time. I've put dollars and physical labor towards the removal of bamboo from my property. It has already destroyed my yard, and I am hoping it will not destroy my house. I look to our local government to assist its citizens with this preventable burden.
Thank you. Helen Ribbons, 10 Gilbert Avenue. Damon Tarantola, 3 Ernst Court, Kings Park.
Good evening, Council. I'm here on behalf of my parents in Kings Park. This is in regards to the Section 14. I'm going to try to do this as fast as I can. Please be advised that such an addition to the present Chapter 221 would be particularly violative of any and all property rights of all property owners who presently maintain such plants on their properties, as well as those who in future may use their property to plant such plants as a function of their free will and enjoyment and free use of their private property, a right guaranteed forever by virtue of the deed filed in a county clerk's office, or kept unfiled by the property owner on the condition that the county school and town real property taxes levied and are maintained pursuant to all applicable New York State real property tax laws. In addition, the passing of any such law interfering with the use and enjoyment of private real property would in fact violate the ex post de facto clause of the federal constitution. Together with numerous tenets of the United States Federal Bill of Rights as well as the New York State Bill of Rights, as a particular and common sense logic, such an addition to the existing code of such an unconstitutional property maintenance code would be unduly burdensome and prejudicial to any of the property owners who presently maintain bamboo on their property and have so for years, or even for the day of that matter. The cost to remove these plants will likely be cost prohibitive to the property owner and thus undue hardship based upon this illegal and unconstitutional proposed code's enactment, and burdensome, prejudicial, and a possibly financial hardship to a disabled or senior citizen property owner who cannot afford to hire a landscape to remove such plants and compelled under the threat of a code violation, an unconstitutional code violation, was forced to remove such plants on her own physical labor. The law in New York State is clear that eco-friendly bamboo plants and their root system on private property in New York State cannot legally constitute a nuisance. It's also been brought to my attention via this letter dated June 10th, 2011, authored by an unknown neighbor of ours, that at least one resident or property owner has already claimed bamboo as a nuisance and sued in the state Supreme Court, presumably Suffolk County. And not surprisingly, the court ruled that bamboo and its root system could not legally constitute a nuisance. Please see the attached letter dated June 10th, 2011. The attempt to add and enact this town of Smithtown property maintenance code in Chapter 221 with the new and added Section 14 appears to be a judicial attempt by the town council to possibly circumvent the nuisance issued, ruled upon the court that established stare decisis and the president as to the bamboo plants and their root system not causing and or representing a legal valid nuisance in the local courts or in all other courts' general jurisdiction within New York State. Please see Ivy V. Column 13, Miss 3D75, 2006.
Thank you. Mary Ann, 56A Rhode Avenue. I can't pronounce that name.
Hey, Christina, give out the letter. Hi, my name is Marian Trecarici, and I reside at 56A Rotor Avenue, Smithtown, with my husband and two children. We have a major problem with bamboo that my next-door neighbor had planted. It has now invaded two homes that never asked for or wanted the bamboo. The roots are growing under my fence and into my backyard, causing damage along the way. It is causing my neighbor's fence to fall onto my property. For the past 3 years, we have had to resod large portions of our backyard to get the roots. Every year, the area gets bigger and bigger. It has shifted and lifted my fence out of alignment. It has lifted several pavers and cracked the cement that they are set in. We are extremely afraid that they will go through the foundation, central air unit, two cesspools, a pool, water and electric lines that run through our backyard, all of which are in the line of destruction. During heavy rain or snowstorms, the bamboo covers our lawn and kitchen window. My family and I cannot enjoy our backyard due to 10 to 15 feet roots that are all over our backyard. I have a sample of one of them that they sprout out all over the place. I feel that it's a safety hazard for my children and the safety of their friends. When I approached my neighbor a couple of weeks ago and I explained that it's very time consuming for my husband to rip up the roots and take care of my backyard, their answer to me was, oh well, if I feel that strong, just keep my kids in the house this summer. I am afraid that the bamboo will puncture through someone's foot. I am also concerned that the bamboo is now spreading towards the street. Several shoots have grown a few feet away from the curb within the last month. I feel that this will cause major problems in September when the bus for Branchbrook Elementary and High School West stop about 5 feet away from the bamboo stalks. I am concerned that this could cause a safety issue, not only for the children, but for the bus driver when the roots grow tall and lean into the streets. Bamboo is a major issue in Smithtown, and please help us. Smithtown is a wonderful place to live and raise children. Thank you.
Thank you. Chris Theofield. He's forward. He'll be forward.
Good evening, Mr. Vecchio and town board members. My name is Chris Theofield, and I live at 50 Oak Avenue in Smithtown. My wife and I purchased our home in April 2005. Our residence, whose backyard backs up to us, purchased their home approximately 3 years ago. I first noticed the bamboo in their yard in the spring of 2010. During the spring of 2010 in April, approximately 6 to 8 feet of the bamboo had spread into my yard underneath my fence, and the shoots had grown up into my yard. Having four small children from the ages of 3 to 7, it's a hazard. I can't have my kids out in the backyard in the springtime with no shoes on or anything because I'm fearful that the bamboo shoots are going to go through their feet. It destroyed approximately 20 feet by 6 feet of an area of sod in my backyard that I had put in. My main concern is really the hazard for my children with this bamboo growing so quickly. I first noticed it last spring. Last spring it spread into my yard. Again, this spring, during the rainy season, it spread into my yard again. Every morning before I had to leave work at 5 in the morning, I went and kicked out the shoots every morning so that my children didn't trip over them. It spreads this quickly. I first noticed it over the top of my 6-foot fence in the spring of 2010, and every year for the last 2 years, I have to go into my backyard and kick down the shoots. When the shoots come up, they're like razor sharp. God forbid it went through my children's feet, I'll tell you, I wouldn't know what I would do, you know? So I definitely think it's a very invasive plant that shouldn't be allowed to be grown anymore in the town of Smithtown. Thank you.
Thank you. Marguerite Baldwin, 83 Elm Avenue.
Good evening. My name is Marguerite Baldwin, and I am a lifelong resident of Smithtown, having lived here for the past 50 years. I reside at 83 Elm Avenue since 1990. I am coming before the board today to ask that you reconsider the wording of the proposed revision to the town code with respect to bamboo. There are hundreds of homeowners in the town of Smithtown who have bamboo in their yards. Like me, most of them inherited the bamboo when they purchased their homes. The slides I have prepared for you were taken on Sunday, June 12th, on a random one-hour drive through the community, most of it on main roads. The bamboo growing in my yard was there for at least 20 years before I purchased my home in 1990. Similarly, the bamboo in the yard behind me was loaded with bamboo when I purchased my home. In fact, it was so overgrown with bamboo that it was actually growing through a brick barbecue in the yard, and due to the negligence of previous homeowners, was all over the yard. This was the condition of the yard when the current owners purchased their handyman special without benefit of an engineer report or home inspection. In fact, they did not even move into the home for over a year because of the condition of the property both in and out. Had they secured a home inspection report, it would have identified the bamboo problem on their property, and they could have negotiated a better price or made the removal of it a condition of the sale. They did not do this. When my neighbors approached the town several years ago to complain about the bamboo, the town advised them that it was a civil matter and to seek relief in the courts. That was the correct response. This matter was adjudicated in September of last year, and the jury returned a decision in our favor in less than 15 minutes. Sworn testimony by an arborist who inspected the properties stated that the bamboo was contained on all four sides except for a small breach in the barrier, which occurred when the neighbor behind us installed a vinyl fence. When he dug one of the posts, he bent the barrier, and that is why the bamboo shoots spread back into his property. The court held last year that the bamboo growing in our yard was and is not a nuisance to the plaintiffs. To pass an amendment to the town code without carving out an exemption for homeowners who already have it in their yards is very unfair. How is one to remove bamboo that has been growing almost 40 years? It would prove a tremendous financial hardship to have excavators come in, tear down fencing, move sheds, cut the trees down, and dig them out. The arborist who testified in court said that it was virtually impossible to totally eradicate it, but that it could be successfully contained when barriers are erected correctly. If we are forced to remove the stand of bamboo in our yard that has been successfully contained, what happens when it grows back? Will code enforcement come back and fine us again? If you can ban something that has grown on Long Island for the past who knows how many years, then the next neighbor might want to ban ivy that is growing from his neighbor's yard, or honeysuckle that can choke an evergreen to death if not cut out regularly. How about mint and ornamental strawberries? Will we legislate against the birds that drop these seeds and spread these invasive plants? I have seen bamboo growing on Lake Avenue, Meadow Road, North Country Road, and Mauritius Road in St. James. Who is going to get rid of all that, the taxpayers? It seems to me that the town is opening a Pandora's box and leaving itself exposed to possible litigation from those homeowners who would not be grandfathered in and exempted from this retrospective amendment as it is currently written. Residents who have bamboo on their property already should take steps to contain it by installing a barrier. You cannot eradicate it because it will come back. My bamboo stand has been contained and I like it. I enjoy the privacy it affords me, especially.
Baldwin, 83 Elm Avenue. Ma'am, you've exceeded your 3 minutes by 2 minutes.
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Good evening, Town Board. My name is Bob Baldwin, 83 Elm Avenue, and there was some comments made about how leaves and roots grow and destroy things. Well, it's all over Long Island. There's leaves, roots that grow and blow onto people's properties that ruin the sidewalks all down Maple Avenue that they just replaced. So bamboo isn't the only thing in the Long Island that ruins things. We bought a house, and when we bought a house in 1990, the five houses around us had the bamboo. We did not plant it. It was there by two previous owners, had it before we even moved into the house. When I put a pool in the year 2000, I cleared my backyard of the bamboo up to 1 foot of the property line, and I put a steel barrier 110 feet across my backyard. The bamboo has not grown through it and is contained on my property. I didn't put anything in the back because the neighbor who lived behind us at the time had 80 feet, and this room isn't even 80 feet. It was 80 feet long and 30 feet deep in his property, which continued to grow to my barrier, but the barrier works. The barrier stopped the bamboo from growing, but the bamboo came from my neighbor's property behind me to my property. It was already on five houses. So I don't think we should be penalized and have to remove our bamboo when I already did it and went through the expense once. Some of the things that were said in the newspaper that Anthony Corbo's in-ground pool was destroyed, he don't have an in-ground pool. He has an above-ground pool. The only thing wrong with his pool, because I serviced his pool, was the rust ate through his liner and he needed a liner change. Bamboo never touched or destroyed his pool. And as far as the house behind us, if the bamboo was there and the bamboo had destroyed whatever it was, their patio, their foundation, the plumbing, whatever, that was done before they bought the house, and the bamboo had already done the damage. So they should have known that and then got an inspection or engineer's report when they bought the house, instead of blaming the people who live behind them and saying it's their fault. When they bought the house, knowing full well the bamboo was there, it was 80 feet wide by 30 foot deep when they purchased the home. So it should have been no surprise of what they were getting. And the other thing is, I have a three-year-old granddaughter that lives with me. She plays in my backyard every single day. She's in the pool. We don't have any problems with the pool, with the filter, with the leaves getting in the skimmers. And she plays back there, and our two dogs run around back there, and we don't have any issues with the bamboo. Thank you for your time.
Did you say that you have a barrier on the side?
And it goes.
And that contains the, the roots. But the rear yard, somebody owned the property behind your end of your yard, and that bamboo penetrated your yard because there is no barrier.
Right. Well, now there's... I have a steel barrier about 8 feet off my property line. There's two barriers on the side, and the people behind us, when they purchased the house, eventually put a barrier down the backyard
So your house, in effect, is not challenged by this ordinance since you already are controlling
it. Yes, it would be because it is contained, but it's within the 10 feet of the property line.
Okay.
It's
I understand.
Totally... in that boundary line.
Okay.
It's 8 feet wide by the width of my property, which is 110 feet long.
Understand.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Glenn Iskowitz, 335 6th Avenue.
Hi, I'm Glenn Iskowitz, 335 6th Avenue. Thank you. And I'm here tonight in support of the proposal that's being put on the floor. I bought my house. My wife and I bought our house in 1995. When we bought the house, there was approximately about a 60-foot long grove of bamboo that went across the northern boundary of my property and the southern boundaries of the properties just to the north of me. In about 2004, we decided we were going to do some major renovations in the backyard, put an in-ground pool and whatever. So We hired an excavator with one of the two neighbors that I just described to take the bamboo out. The other neighbor decided he liked the bamboo and didn't want to take it out, and therein lies our problem. I commend those tonight who've talked about on their own, of their own accord, putting in major barrier work, and I think it's great that it's containing it. Our case is different. We have a neighbor who doesn't want to contain his bamboo, doesn't want to deal with his bamboo. It's destroyed fencing in my backyard. It's destroyed landscaping in my backyard. It's prohibited us from doing patio work down the northern side of the back of the house. And so, you know, in our case, I think it's a little bit different. And I think what's being said tonight would work great for people in our situation. You know, just listening to everybody and thinking about what's fundamentally fair for everybody, just maybe a suggestion to consider is grandfathering those who have some kind of really aggressive root control in place already. And I think that would sort of keep everything status quo, but also give the town the teeth to protect people like me who have a neighbor with bamboo who doesn't want to deal with how invasive it is. So anyway, thank you. That's all I wanted to say.
Thank you. Patricia Fuchs, 3 Wexford Court, St. James.
Hi, my name is Patricia Fuchs. I live at 3 Wexford Court in St. James. I am aware and understand the concern of bamboo growing in our town, and it actually saddens me that I've heard tonight that some residents who do own bamboo are not concerned so much about their neighbors' yards. But as a taxpaying citizen, resident and U.S. citizen, I feel I should not be told what I can and cannot plant on my property as long as it stays on my property. I am, years ago we had planted bamboo along our property line because we were in need of some privacy. When we planted the bamboo, we were under the impression or understanding that it was the not a spreading variety. But a few years later, we were proven wrong, and we actually have a built-in pool in the further back of our yard. So at that time, we noticed it was starting to spread a little bit towards our pool area, and we had placed a barrier. We didn't do the full length of the property line. We only did a portion by our pool because we had some concrete work that we needed done around the pool. That worked partially because it was at ground level. Anyway, since then we investigated with Cornell University and to find out exactly how deep the barrier had to be. It had to be above the ground a few inches so you could always see if these shoots kind of go over the barrier, then you can clip them and keep them in check. Since then also the bamboo has grown over into my neighbor's yard. We have offered to remove it from his yard, and we are in the process of completing the barrier in the front portion along the property line. But my main complaint is that I am a homeowner. I already have it growing on my property line. It's definitely, you know, the barrier, I have enclosed it on all four sides. It's like totally enclosed, and it will be when we finish, like we did one length and then we have some more to do. So it'll be totally contained. And in the 10-foot section, you know, is going too much into my yard. It's a side yard, and my house is not too far off of that. So that's about all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you. Vincent Murphy, 295 7th Avenue, St. James. Sharon Murphy, 5 Ernst Court. Sorry, you'll be next. You here? No, he's not here. Sharon Murphy.
Good evening. I'd like to thank the council members for having this this important issue on the agenda. I'm here tonight to say I fully support the proposed amendment. Our neighbor has bamboo growing on their property, and not everyone is responsible for containing the bamboo. So that means the bamboo is growing on our property, and so every day I have to inspect the property. My husband and I inspect it to cut down the bamboo because it grows very quickly. Also, I don't think it's fair to financially be responsible for hiring someone to remove the bamboo if we were not the ones who planted it. In regards to the issue of homeowners being grandfathered in, those who plant the bamboo, I oppose that because let's say my neighbor, if this amendment, if landowners were grandfathered in, that means my problem would still exist because the bamboo will still be growing on that property and that my neighbor would not be required to remove the bamboo as well. I also suggest that those individuals who plant bamboo and who are not responsible at containing it should be financially responsible for their neighbors. I do commend those individuals who are containing the bamboo because I really think that's the responsible thing to do, and thank you. However, not everyone is as responsible for containing their bamboo, and it is a hardship, and it's very time-consuming to go out and remove the bamboo. Thank you.
Thank you. David O'Connell, 92 Riviera Drive, Kings Park.
Thank you, Board. My name is David O'Connell. I live at 92 Riviera Drive. My neighbor next to me had planted bamboo 16 years ago, and I watched it grow from a 20-foot little section to now. It's required me to excavate my property, install 175-foot of bamboo barrier, which is still ineffective. The bamboo does jump over it, and where the bamboo meets the curb, there is no manufacturer recommendation with how to make this barrier meet concrete or any existing structures. In addition, when the excavation was done and the trenching was done, which is 36 inches, I had to have this trench go through existing trees, which I wanted to maintain. Since then, both those trees have died. I lost a 65-foot willow tree and a 50-foot swamp maple. I am entirely supportive of a ban for bamboo. It cannot be controlled. I can demonstrate if I have, and I'm going to request here formally that a code enforcement officer come to my house and I'll demonstrate at the neighbor's property it's growing under the road and showing up in the tidal wetlands now. In addition, I've lost my power 4 times because my neighbor has not maintained his bamboo and now it's taken out my power lines. Every season in the wintertime it becomes snow laden, and I've had oil deliveries that are not allowed to come. The drivers have turned away because the snow laden bamboo is laid on top of my oil tank. It's a hazard in the lawn. My kids have not been able to use my side yard or my backyard because the spears are dangerous. They come up through the grass and they are sharp and hard at the grass height. You can't even see them, but they hurt. Propose an amendment to your proposal that it is a ban, and if at least you have a restriction, not just 10 feet, but I agree with the 40 feet, because these do, they travel far, and they pop up 30, 40 feet away, and that's it. Thank you, Board.
Thank you. Kristen L. Broderick, Fifth Avenue, 326 Fifth Avenue, St. James.
Whoops. Okay. I'm going to wreck the place. Okay.
Good evening. My name is Kristen L. Broderick. I live at 326 Fifth Avenue, St. James. I've had bamboo. My mother planted bamboo on our property 55 years ago, and it's still there. I'm in the house now. This was her choice. It's grown there, and it has not been a problem, okay? I know that you have to take care of it. You have to maintain it. The only way you can maintain it, though, is by digging up the roots. If you don't dig up the roots, you're going to have it all the time, and then you have to place a barrier where you want it to stop. The other thing that I've heard here so many times tonight is people say that it has laid over and stopped oil deliveries. Bamboo is light as a feather. All you have to do, if that branch is coming over, you just flick the water off it and it pops right back up. That's, yeah, well, it goes back up. I mean, I have it on my property and it I make it go back up by flicking off the water and ice. And I think that it's wrong of the town of Smithtown to tell us what to be able to grow on our property. And I do believe, though, that a barrier should be put in if you can put it in. But if it's already growing on somebody else's property and has been there for 30 years, that's not my problem. That would be that other party's problem. They would have to address that. And when you buy a piece of property, if it's there, just like in anything else, it's buyer beware. Thank you.
Thank you. And all the speakers, so I'm going to move to.
Yes. I also have an email letter from Mr. Michael Cleary in protest of the proposed audience that we're going to put in the record.
Okay. I'll move to close the hearing.
Sir, I did forget to mention one thing.
Well, you better come up there and.
Mike.
Again, David O'Connell, 92 Riviera Drive. If anybody knows the street, it's 92, it's Riviera Drive, just north of St. John and Birch, the intersection. It's known as the Bamboo Road. And because of this, the town of Smithtown will check with their highway department every single year, categorically, every single storm, they've had to dispatch crews with payloaders to clear the road. The road is down to one lane, and it's unmaintained because of the snow and ice, and somebody has to do something about it. It's costing the town highway department money and me money. Thank you. Yes, it does. The bamboo is snow-laden, laying across the road.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I'll move to close the hearing.
Supervisor, that's one more person.
Excuse me, sir. I wrote nobody called my name.
Okay.
Thank you for hearing me. Good evening, members of the council. I've been, my name is Dan Tarantola. My address is 3 Ernest Court, Kings Park. I've been a homeowner for 25 years in Smithtown, paying my taxes. When I bought my home, all the homes had bamboo on them. So when I've contained it for 25 years, I have not had a problem. I have a pool. I have children. I've never had a problem with the bamboo. I have a barrier on both sides, and I haven't really had a problem. We love it. I have a wife who is a cancer survivor victim, and she likes her privacy. It affords us a lot of privacy after 25 years with the trees on the property. I don't think it's fair that my neighbors have maintained their side as well. I don't think it's fair that at this point, we should be penalized for having the plants on our property. If it was a new property and it was a new precedence, I certainly wouldn't have had it there. Or in the beginning when they were small and they were just seedlings, I would have removed it. So I just feel that at this point, we should be, the people that do have it should be grandfathered in. It would be an astronomical cost for me to remove the trees and to do a new planting. Yes, so long as it's maintained. I haven't had a problem maintaining
it. So you say you do have a barrier?
Yes.
So this
yes.
ordinance wouldn't affect you?
Oh, okay. And would we be grandfathered in if we have it? Oh, well, my trees are along the borderline. I've removed trees and, you know, so I've had
so yes,
no problem.
It would affect you.
Thank you.
Unless you move the barrier back 10 feet.
But it's right up against my property line, and that's the way I've cultivated, and I haven't had a problem. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll move to close the hearing.
Second.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Afterwards.
What's that?
Is there a Judy Rowe here?
That's after the, this is road crop, so this is after the.
I don't have to do that.
Okay.
Is Judy Rowe here?
Only wait for these people to leave.
No.
Wait for leave.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you please, we have a continuing of the meeting here.
Good evening. I have nothing to do with the bamboo. I'm right here in relation to the condition of our roads in our area. I live on Tanglewood Drive, which is right off 111, and if you know the condition of 111, our area is constantly being used as egress going from one side of 111 over to Brookside Drive. I spoke with Mr. Ryan when he was a superintendent of highways. He understood our condition of our roads, so that was, let's see, 2010, I guess it was, 2010. Anyway, since he lost the election, I then wrote to the new superintendent of highways. I never received a response. About a month ago, we received this flyer in the mail, which is signed, it's not anonymous, concerning steps taken by one of our neighbors. He's been in contact with legislator Mr. Kennedy, and also I gather from town councilman Ed Wernheim about the condition of these roads. There are 127 roads listed to be repaired in the budget for next year, or this year, into each other. Ours is not on there. And if you ride our roads at all, you would think you're on a country road. I've been in this community for 53 years. I've never seen the road in such condition as it is now. What I'm asking you is to suggest what we can do in the next step to do something about these roads. That's why I'm here. What is our next step?
What did Mr. Ryan, the new superintendent, tell you?
He supposedly, according to this, has not responded to the Wieners whatsoever.
Okay.
I wrote a letter. He's not responded to my letter, which I wrote in the fall.
Did you say Mr. Wareheim was involved with this?
According to this item, this article, they've been in touch with him.
Yeah, he's written. Okay. I have received correspondence, which I have sent over to Mr. York.
So, okay.
If he has not responded, I will follow up on
okay,
that.
Because supposedly, as of, I spoke with the Wieners 2 weeks ago. He has not been in contact with them. That was 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
So
we'll recontact him.
Okay, because I just want to know what the next step we can do to make our
well,
the
next
top
step
of the list.
Is, you've told us, Mr. Wareheim indicated he will contact Superintendent Jorgensen.
Okay.
If he can't find it in his means to do it this year, maybe we could encourage him to do it next year.
That's what we were hoping. I mean,
okay.
Supposedly we were promised by Mr. Ryan it would be done this year. And
Mr. Wareheim will follow that up, I assure you.
I appreciate that very
okay,
much.
Okay,
thank you.
Rosalind Palazzolo.
I have several times complained about the corner of Edgewood Avenue and Landing when it comes to making a left turn. Everybody else who makes a left turn at Landing or Edgewood has a proper protection. They get a turning light and they have time to turn. The only time you can make a left-hand turn on Edgewood to go to Town Hall is if somebody is making a left turn to go up Landing Avenue from Edgewood, they have a turning light. And when you're making a left hand from Edgewood to go to Landing, to go on to Landing, to go over the railroad tracks, you do not have safety. Today I had a sad experience because the light was red facing me on Edgewood Avenue, and then the turning light came on, but the cars in front of me, there was one car, he went straight, and then there's another car waiting to turn, and all of a sudden I hear this siren. I am stopped, and this man in front of me started to move, and I followed him. Luckily, the car's coming up from Edgewood, from Jericho. The man had stopped, and it was bumper to bumper because the red light had just turned to green, and there was enough space for him to go through, and I followed him because they had stopped, even though they had the green light to go. And then the emergency police car was right behind me. I could not get out of this man's way because I was stopped, even though there was a green light at that corner. I don't understand how you could make it safe for three of those intersections. They could turn safely, and yet if I go to Town Hall, I can't turn safely. Why can't they put another traffic light there and make it so that I can make a safe turn, because it's a 15-second right, left-hand turn, and after that, you can't go anymore because it's green and all the cars are coming up. So I can't understand why we have a traffic director, why he can't make it safe for four turns and only make it safe for three turns. And I really got scared today when I had this police siren car behind me, because there was no way I could go even into the turning lane that turns right. I couldn't get out of that person's way.
Mr. Malloy is making note of your comments. He will contact the traffic director.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Sitting as the Board of Water Commissioners, the Board of Water Commissioners will authorize the following transfers to the following accounts as per 125.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareham?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Town Board Supervisor to appoint Diane Whiting to the Youth Advisory Board for term of office from June 24th, 2011 to 2013. Town Board to authorize the clerk to advertise for public hearing to be held at on July 2011 to consider a petition as submitted by St. Catherine of Siena Medical Center for a special exception.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareham?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Building Department report is on file with the clerk. Parade walk run, Smithtown, second, first reading. Parade run walk for Kings Park High School, first reading. Town Board to award the following bids and authorize the purchase of associated goods and services as per A and B of the agenda.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareham?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Town Board to award the following request for proposal, an RFP for video security upgrades at Long Beach Marina.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareham?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Town Board to approve the following designation of electrical inspectors, environmental analysts to attend the hazardous materials seminar, an amendment to the declaration of covenants and restrictions filed with Suffolk County Clerk, an amendment of a resolution of the town board meeting to read as per the agenda, Department of Public Safety to apply for United States Department of Homeland Security for a grant to facilitate the replacement of a Marine unit, Peter Johnson to end New York State Assessors Association seminar, a waiver of a hearing and stipulated agreement with Suffolk County Department of Health Services, Senior Citizens Department to lease a copier, Town Board approves the supervisor's appointment of Diana Whiting, the acceptance of the attached proposal from RT Environmental Associates to provide testing and emissions estimates, acceptance of the attached proposal from Wareham Energy Corporation to provide engineering services for the design of a permanent landfill gas flare, And lastly, retain the professional services of Frank Mooney, former town engineer, at a rate of $150 per hour, not to exceed $3,000.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Town board to issue a negative declaration for site plan approval by Hypnotic Bar and Grill.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Town board to accept donations from in the amounts of $50, $100, and $25.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes, town board to approve of transfers as per the agenda items A, B, C, D, E, and F.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. The town board to authorize the supervisor to execute the following on a form approved by the town attorney, an intermunicipal agreement between the town and the town of Islip Resource Recovery Agency, a lease agreement between the town and the county of Suffolk, a transportation assistance program agreement between the town and Suffolk County.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Is town board to authorize the release of a cashier's check as per the agenda item?
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
The town board to approve all the following personnel matters, exclusive of D, A through T.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. You've got that exclusive of D?
D, yes.
Yes. Okay. I move to close the meeting.
We have some
I'm sorry. We have all the town board to authorize the building director to perform an inspection of the premises known as the Bavarian Inn in Lake Ronkonkoma, pursuant to the town code 115, buildings and unsafe structures. Furnish a report and recommendation to the town board.
Well, we need a second.
Second.
Okay. Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Mr. Clerk, I'm reading this as a town board in mass, so I don't know that you need a second.
Okay.
Town board to accept the conveyance of a surplus parcel of real property from the county of Suffolk, and the town board to approve the conveyance of the aforesaid surplus real property to the 9/11 responders, Remembered Park Incorporated, and further authorize the supervisor to execute a quitclaim deed.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Okay. Town board to authorize a part-term appointment of Emily Gibson to the position of student intern in the Department of Planning and Community Development.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Town board to approve a title and salary change for Joseph Sardo to laborer and a rate of pay of $750.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes. Town board to approve seasonal appointments for the attached list of various parks and positions in the Parks Department effective June 24th.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
Town board to approve the seasonal reappointment of Kelsey Johnson as a student intern at a rate of pay $8 an hour.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.
Supervisor Vecchio?
I'll move to close the meeting.
Second.
We're going to be signing some site plans.
Okay, the town board will be signing how many site plans?
Two site plans.
Two site plans at the end of the meeting.
Okay.
Call the roll.
All right, Supervisor Vecchio?
Yes.
Councilman Malloy?
Yes.
Councilman Creighton?
Yes.
Councilman Wareheim?
Yes.